I'm Paul McGinnis. I'm with Purdue North Central. I am the Vice Chancellor of Enrollment Management and Student Services.
Amy Davis-Navardauskas, Alumni Relations and Annual Fund.
And we're out at our campus, Purdue North Central, and we're actually hosting, along with the local community, the American Veterans Traveling Tribute, AVTT. It is a memorial that honors the Vietnam veterans, also veterans from World War I, II, Korea, Vietnam again, and everything related to the Middle East with Operation Desert Storm and SHIELD through the War on Global Terror. We're hosting this from the 3rd through the 7th. Our closing ceremony will be on the 7th at 11 a.m. We've had a lot of distinguished guests, a lot of people that have been involved everywhere from the Wall Gang, the Patriot Guard, and our good friends at WJOB who have helped us out. And Amy, I think a lot of people have contributed a lot, both gift in kind and also with their donations.
Yes, there have been a number, not just a small number, but a large number of people who have donated in-kind services, such as the crane that's over, you know, holding this flag that you can see behind us, and many, many different things, such as water for volunteers, food for volunteers. I can't even name them all, but there are many, many volunteers that have come out and people that have donated their treasure to help us with this event.
So this large crane behind us with this beautiful flag is from Tun and Blank.
Correct.
Construction. So they were nice enough to not only contribute the crane, but a station or an operating engineer, I believe, that came out.
I believe so. I believe there's an engineer that's on call that we can call if there's any kind of problems with the flag catching wind or anything like that.
So if it's a storm comes and we got to lower it, operating engineers here to bring it down. And then our traffic has been great despite the heat. It unfortunately, people don't seem to stay as long, but they seem to just come through, find a loved one, pay the respects, and then move on. And I know that the estimate was that we had close to 500 for the opening ceremony. Is that right?
That's what I've heard.
Yeah. And we had former governor, Joe Kernan, who is a POW from Vietnam, and he had spoke along with Senator Jim Arnold. And I believe it was Brigadier General David Wood, who came up from Indianapolis, who is one of the commanding officers down at the Indiana National Guard. And if you're interested in finding and paying your respects and coming out to the memorial, once again, we will be here through the 7th. And I think this has been such a rewarding experience for the community and both for the campus that I think we have aspirations of continuing to do things with our veterans. The university and the community is committed to it. We look at the different VFW posts, and we do have what's called the Wall Gang Command Center. The Wall Gang has been here 24 hours a day. Just wonderful with their volunteer time and efforts. And I think with this kind of response, it's something that we want to look to in the future. Maybe we can even bring the wall back in a number of years. And I know that from an advancement standpoint, you'd probably be pretty involved with that, right?
Yeah, the advancement office would handle any kind of donations that would come in that would be what we call gift in kind donations or actual cash donations that would come in. So we can still accept donations if you're interested in coming out and would like to honor the wall by making a donation to help help pay for the proceeds of the project. Anything beyond the scope of this project, all those remaining dollars will be donated to veterans' causes. So your help is greatly appreciated.
So I think it's probably important that we tell the listeners that this is not a Purdue event that we're looking at raising any money for the university. All proceeds go to either this event or to veterans groups that try to help veterans and, you know, any issues that they may have from the conflicts and war they're involved in. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct.
So once again, I want to actually just be able to tell everyone that's viewing this video that and if you're a veteran or served in some capacity in our services, thank you very much. We appreciate it. Purdue is proud of your service, and we want to thank you for everything you've done for our country. And hopefully if you haven't had a chance to come out this time, in the future we'll bring them back, and we'll see you then.
John Barron with American Veterans Traveling Tribute. Our mission basically is to travel the country and just provide a forum for communities to come together to honor, respect, and remember all of those we've asked to protect and defend our way of life as we know it. This includes our veterans, our active duty military, our police, our fire. What you see in the displays out in the field in front of us is an 80% replica of the Vietnam Wall. We also have tributes to World War II and Korea. We've got casualty listings of our soldiers lost from 1980 to 2001. All of the casualties of 9/11 are listed. Then we have a unique display that's only one of its kind that I know of, which is the gold dog tag display. That is all of the combat casualties for the War on Terror, Iraq, Afghanistan, those locations over there. It's current through end of May right now. And, you know, sadly, we have to keep updating that one pretty regularly at this point. Said it's just an honor and a privilege for us to get to bring the displays to people that otherwise wouldn't get to see them.
How many states do you go to?
We were in 37 states last year, and we'll probably hit that many this year. We travel all over the lower 48 states. Have not been to Hawaii and Alaska yet, and that's not for lack of trying on our part. But
how long does this take you?
We travel from about March 1st through the end of November, typically. And we rely heavily on volunteers in the various communities to help us set up and take down the displays when it's time to move on. On average, about once a week, we'll set it up and take it down.
My name's John Coggins. I'm the Assistant Vice Chancellor of Student Services here and Dean of Students. This is the Veterans Tent, and the Veterans Tent is kind of just a welcome tent for any veteran who wants to stop by if they have any questions or if they have any concerns. We'll just talk with them, and we also have cards here for any student who is a veteran who might want to start coming to Purdue North Central. They can have a resource person then and know who to talk to about getting enrolled and financial aid and anything like of that sort. We're pretty happy with the people who've been coming here. We had one student come in, or I should say one person come by here in on Wednesday night, and he was a former editor of the student newspaper. And he had all of the newspapers from 1972 and gave it to us. So that was pretty neat, I thought. But we've had other veterans who stop by and just want to kind of expound upon their feelings about what a great event this is and how fortunate the community is that this event is here.
Good morning. My name is Rich Murozinski from Rolling Prairie, Indiana. Vietnam veteran. I served in the United States Air Force. I was in Vietnam from April 1970 till November of 1971. And was at Thuy Hoa, Cameron Bay, and Da Nang. Been part of the committee to bring this moving wall here to Purdue. I've been to Washington, D.C. several times to see the real wall. I can tell you that the feeling is the same here as it is in Washington. I look at these 58,000 plus names on here and realize that every one of them had a family, and every family had to suffer losing a loved one in the defense of their country. Three of these names on this wall are guys I went to school with, and one was an altar boy with me at Catholic Church. I have a feel of pretty close tie to all these names. Even though I only personally knew three, I call all of them my brothers. And it's a great thing for us to have this here today at Purdue. Even though the weather is really brutal out here, somebody asked me, how long can you stay out in this heat? I said, well, I did it for 18 months at one point, but I was a lot younger then. But it's a great thing to have here. We've had some pretty good crowds, and I'm really very proud to be a part of the group that brought this traveling tribute to the campus.
My name is Ed Smith. I'm from Union Mills, Indiana. I was in the United States Air Force and served in Vietnam from December of 1969 till December of 1970. I served in Tan Son Air Base outside of Saigon, and very honored to be here to see this display that so much honors our veterans and the rest of the display that we definitely need it for our departed comrades and that.
Thank you. Okay, when I came home from Vietnam, I went there April of 70 till November of 71, and the way Vietnam veterans were treated was deplorable. I remember waiting in the airport in Seattle, where they kept us in a little room in the back of the airport. They told us, when your plane gets here, we'll come and get you. And they'd let us down the hallway, stay to the left side, and don't pay any attention to the people out there that are going to be giving you a hard time. And I couldn't believe what I was seeing. After I got home, I just kind of wanted to forget about being a Vietnam veteran, because public sentiment was they hated the war and they hated the warrior. I can tell you that as a veterans advocate, there's no Vietnam veteran is ever going to let that happen again to the troops coming home today. If you don't agree with the war, that's one thing. Don't take it out on the warrior. They put their life on the line. They put their life on hold to serve their country, and they need to be recognized for that. And we vow that we will never let that happen to another American veteran, that they be treated with respect and thank them for serving their country, not disrespect them the way we were disrespected when we came home from Vietnam.